Hello, Garrett here with Partzilla.com, and today I'm going to teach you how to do a valve adjustment on a Kawasaki Mule 3000. It's a simple job, just need to remove the flywheel cover, the valve covers, and adjust the valves. So let me go grab a few tools and we can turn wrenches. Okay, the first thing we're going to do is we're going to remove the shift linkage cable from the bracket. It's held in place with two nuts. Then we'll remove the four 12 millimeter bolts that hold the bracket to the side of the engine. That way we can remove our flywheel cover. Now we'll just disconnect the last three 10 millimeter bolts that hold the cover in place. We got to take this cover off to be able to set the engine to top dead center. I'll show you more about that in just a second. Next thing we want to do is remove both the spark plugs. That way we will relieve the compression on the engine and it makes it easier to turn it over to set top dead center. All right, now we're going to take the flywheel and we're going to spin it in a clockwise rotation to where the number one arrow on the flywheel matches the arrow directly above it on the crankcase, just like that. Now we should be set to top dead center. So we're gonna remove our valve cover. It's held in place with four 10 millimeter bolts. Now we're gonna check to see if the rocker arms are loose. And as you see here, they are loose. But if yours are not, you need to spin the flywheel an additional rotation and line it up with the same two marks, the number one on the flywheel and the arrow directly above it. Now let's test our clearance. This valve's too loose. There's no resistance sliding the 10,000ths filler gauge in there. So keep that in mind. You want it to be set to 10,000ths, so have those handy. And this top valve is too tight. So looks like we're gonna need to adjust these. So now we simply remove the locking nut. Just back it off just a little bit. That way we can turn the adjustment knob. So we're gonna slide the filler gauge in and then tighten our adjustment knob until we feel it make contact with the filler gauge. Once it makes contact, that means it's set to 10,000, which is Kawasaki specs. So once we've got it set, we're gonna lock our locking nut back down. Just like that. And we're gonna test it again, just to be sure. Good resistance in and out on the valve, so this one's set. Let's move on to the top valve. Now remember, this valve was too tight, so we're gonna need to back it off a little bit. So we're gonna unscrew it, slide the filler gauge in, and then tighten it down until it makes contact. Slide it back and forth. I've got good resistance here. So now we're gonna lock the nut back down. Just like that. Now let's put our valve cover back on and you just repeat the process. Okay, now before we move on to the number two cylinder, we're gonna spin our flywheel again another rotation, and this time line it up with number two on the flywheel, just like that. Now we're going to move on towards the front valve cover. It's held in place the same way as the rear one, except for we have to remove this breather hose, and it's only held in place by two clamps, and it'll pull right off. Now using the same 10,000ths feeler gauge, we're gonna repeat the process we did with the rear head. We're gonna slide it in, and as you can tell here, I've got good resistance forward and backwards. So I'm gonna check the other valve, and I'm getting good resistance here. So this head's good, we can put it back together. Up next is reinstalling the spark plugs. Now be careful and don't cross thread them when you go to put them in, because if you do, it's gonna make for a bad day. And remember to hook your spark plug boots back up. That way it'll actually start when you go to crank it up. Now all we have to do now is simply install the flywheel by reversing the steps we made to take it off. So we're gonna mount our shift linkage bracket with the 4 12-millimeter bolts. Tighten our shift linkage to the bracket. And install the last 3 10-millimeter bolts that hold the flywheel in place. Well, okay, job's all done. Really wasn't that tough, was it? And you saved yourself some cash because you didn't drag it to a pesky dealer. Listen, for a complete list of parts and tools used in this video, check the description below. For more content like this, like us on Facebook or subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you need any parts, come find us online at Partzilla.com.